Let's Hunt is a video series with tactics, weapons, locations, and other useful tips, always around one particular animal. You can hunt Roosevelt elk in a lot of places. I'm choosing Redfeather Falls because here there are just a lot of Roosevelt elk, and even when I'm getting ready to just make a little introduction, I'm already getting the first call. I'm starting my hunt at 8 in the morning. This is way off Darkwood Lodge over in the east. And here we have Roosevelt elk and some black bears and nothing else. So this is really exclusive as far as the inventory. I'm bringing the Unschütz rifle because it's got a nice selection of scopes. I'm bringing the tree stand as well. Maybe we can do a kill or two off the tree. The collar, the scent. And I'm bringing also the deer collar because sometimes when we go further, there will be deer. And sometimes we have to take them out as well. And today I'll be shooting some tracer arrows with the bow, so you can see how good or how bad my shooting is. And here's a little excursus on what kind of camo clothes I can wear against deer. Roosevelt elk is a deer species. I could wear sneaky 3D summer camo here in Redfeather Falls, giving me great visual reduction but no other reduction. And there's all kinds of combinations. But for today, I'm going to choose Boone and Crockett just because many have that. And so you can compare and see how it works. So let's go after this elk, or these elk. This can be, here at Redfeather Falls, this can be single males, or a single male, or two, three males. It can be one male and the number of cows, five cows. Or it can be a big group, even up to six males. Right now I'm hunting with the wind, which is a bit dangerous. Scent eliminator is always good to have or to use. And with the collar for elk, you're getting responses. There's a new trail, that means there is another male. So it's not the male with the cows, with the females, it is actually at least two bulls. I can see at least four. With any herds, like with any herds, try to see them all and take out the best one. The ones I've seen so far, none of them is any good. But there's one back here as well. Ooh, there's a lot. So there is a bunch of cows as well. So right now I'm luring a herd of bulls and a herd of cows. Why don't we use the scent spray and then just move to the side before they see me. I'm wearing Boone and Crockett. It's not depending on there being trees or no trees. They just sense me a little less no matter where I am. If there is any large male, then you have to be careful. Moving around like this will be dangerous. They have better senses. possible that they don't walk straight to the scent location because of that hill in front of me here with the rocks. Sometimes they take a detour. So as far as the location, as far as the starting place, starting time, this never fails me. Sometimes it takes a bit longer to find the first herd. Sometimes I find black bear tracks. I haven't been brave enough yet to put a black bear or a bear bait barrel in this area. I don't think it's gonna yield enough. Oh, this one looks nice. That's certainly the largest male. I think we can get him with the bow from here. Well, not now. You're in the way. Hello. So they're all walking to the scent location, and then from there anywhere. So if I'm lucky, the big bull will come first when I call them over here. Is that also a male? So we have six males. I would assume group of five bulls plus a male and the rest with the cows. Can be tricky if there's a whole herd around and you want to get one specific bull. So the call did not impress them. Right now they're still walking away. The daylight, by the way, for the animals doesn't matter. They will see you or not see you. It's just you that sees less. So my friend, they are still confused. Quite thrilling also if you play competitions. For example, the one with the bow, you need to get one in particular. But also if you fail and you miss or you shoot it badly, then you can always go after them. You will find them. They're still not sure what to do. If you call, you have to move away. Don't stay there. Or they will walk on top of you. So it's getting tricky already. Here's the big one. Oh boy, this one is too close. Let's go for the shot here. So that was in the last second. Oh, by the way, they're still there. That is the silent python bow. They're looking at me. Just lay flat and they will move on. So the python bow is really a silent bow. Very reliable as well over short distances. The guys over here didn't even notice. So maybe I can get a second one. I don't know what happened with the cows. Nice antlers. Yeah, we should get this one as well. Unless we behave too clumsy. The trees give you some cover, so stay behind the trees. They cannot look through solid objects. That would be too much. Oh wow, that's another nice one. I fear he sees me. Okay, so that was enough. Now they run. At least in this direction. Sometimes you wonder, other animals being rather close, you think they spooked as well, but they're still there. Okay, let's go collect them, see what we got. Still one there. Cannot be a high scoring animal. Double lungs. Maybe there's still a few around. So let's stay low. This one is probably just barely over 300, 326. Okay, so there's nothing else to get here from these herds. Let's move on. So let me show the road or the route that I'm going to take. So this is a route I'm taking very often, going from the tent towards Darkwood Lodge. You can do the long loop to the south, or you can shortcut, go by the lodge and then go up north. The icons show what kind of animals you can expect there. The larger the icon, the more you will find of these animals. So usually when I start, I just walk around until I hear a herd or an animal. There's always a call. Well, I shouldn't say always, most of the times. There will be a call very soon, and then after that, I just run around. I save a lot of time. It's a large area. Red Feather is about double the size as the other maps, so if you want to cover that route going up north, then if you just walk, then you will spend easily 2 hours here. So I'm more successful running around and looking for tracks. So that's what I'm going to do then. And I was just running here looking for tracks and I had another call from about here. So let's go check that guy out. And of course it's gonna be interesting whether he's alone or whether he brings some cousins. Oftentimes I find a single bull or a pair, two bulls, three bulls. There's different configurations walking around here, different group sizes. Helps to mark the position on the hunter mate on the map, because once you start moving around, at least I do tend to forget where actually the call came from. And since there is no response, I'm guessing there's really only one. There he is. Of course, shooting the gun is very loud, so. If there's anything around now, it'll have spooked. Very nice gun, very strong, this Unschütz rifle. I like using it. And certainly over a short distance, not a problem at all. Get rid of the dot, and again run around and look for tracks. Here I find a group of females. There's a lot more, not a lot, but there's more females around. You will find many of these here. So I'm just looking if there's a male going along. And if that is not the case, I will just move on. Here is a male. And here is a male. That is a new herd of males. And they are freaking close. 6 minutes away. I'm pretty sure I have spooked them. Not super heavy. This one is even less heavy. So what I'm going to do is I will check out which one is the largest and go after that. .440. The maximum weight is 500 kilograms. There's the first bear. So anything that goes up to 500 kilograms, of course, is a good elk. Larger elks tend, bulls tend to have better antlers. Here's another bear. Here is another male. I haven't counted, but this looks like a lot of animals right now. So I will switch to walking. There's always a chance that I haven't really spooked them. This one has been fleeing. And this one appears to be the largest male, going up to 440 kilograms. This one says 430. The tracking level is 20, so the tracks are rather accurate. The range is rather small. And I'm pretty sure I have spooked them. So let's exercise going after a spooked elk then. Pretty sure I will find fleeing tracks very soon. So here it is. So let's pretend this is a big one and I will just track it down. It can take a while. Let's look, it's 8:40, 9, 8:50, 25 real minutes going in this session, and in about 5 to 10 minutes he should have calmed down. Do I hear steps? The females will calm down sooner. But these guys, it'll take a few minutes, so let's go after it. The first male has calmed down. And here is a bear in front of us. Very small female. Maybe we can get this one in addition. But we'll have to use the bow or we will scare everything else again. If this was a larger bear, I would not be able to come this close. They are very, have very good senses. She's giving me the side, which is good. And again, the python bow, very silent. I'm absolutely sure I haven't spooked anything. You can try and use the caller. Maybe it's going to respond, but you will also attract animals towards you, which can be tricky. Oh, he was fleeing a second time 12 minutes ago, so it's gonna take a little longer. Of course, if there's a lot of animals, like here, a big herd of males, and maybe the females were also around. Then once they spook, they run in all directions. But just keep going after the tracks. They can't hide anywhere. The second fleeing track is always difficult to find. I don't think it's down here. The cone shows which direction that the animal was facing, really, when it started running. Not really where it went. That's why the cone is often wrong. It's always best to go straight ahead in the direction where you were coming, because you spooked it, and usually the animals run away straight away from you in a straight line. So if you go into that direction, that's giving you the best success. There he is. He's got some crown points. No, he's not really big. 250 at max, at most. Here is another new track. Wow. There's really a lot of elk here. Again, not super big. If you ever see 500 as the upper number of the estimation range, then you want to go after it. That's when you find the really big ones. By the way, this gadget is not going to give you anything for Boone and Crockett. It's only telling you if you are protected, if you're wearing the summer camo or the whatever is 3D, sneaky 3D, or the ghillie suit. But anything that is species specific, the app will not tell you anything. just when I turned off the camera, it is calling our bull that we were after. Not anything fancy. Maybe I can get two actually. With my calling, I might attract the other guy as well. I've been using the Python quite a bit because just of that, you shoot animals and you can keep going and shoot more animals in the same area. Every gunshot will just flush everything. They regroup. Once they flee, they find each other. Depends on how they flee. If they flee in a star form, if you're in the middle, then they have a hard time finding each other. But if they all run away from you as a group, they regroup. Oh, here he is. Using the tree as a cover. There's so many bulls here today. Wow. Yeah, that wasn't a great shot. I think I just hit one lung. This one got double lungs. It's a rather large animal. So I hit one lung. Not both of them. And not the heart. The shot was a little bit too high. Okay, I'm not expecting any other large bull here. But I'm open for surprises. No, that's the same herd. They ran, they regrouped, they came back to the call as a herd. But there's no new tracks here. So let's look at the map. Yes, I'm gonna run west and then up north. Another new track. Maybe one of the cows from a former herd. Oh, I think it's a new group. That is another new group of females. I think the starting time actually matters. I see different results at different times. I That's a good size bear. So yes, the starting time matters, and 7 or 8 in the morning is usually not too bad here for elk. So what do we do? Go after the bear? Look for more tracks? Yeah, we'll look for more elk. The bear is rather close, maybe 20 minutes away, it said on the time estimation, a little bit more. So we would have seen that in a few minutes. That's part of the game. You have a route in mind, or a route, and you end up somewhere completely different. That's what makes it so interesting. We're coming towards the river, a little bit more open here. So I've seen the last tracks over here, been running. And here I'm going a bit slower. Because of the view, you can see animals sometimes, and we get a deer, white tail for sure, a black tail. Yeah, they can come down here. So that's why I have the deer collar. I want to take them out as well in between elk hunts. Of course, the black tails can also be in groups here. Most of the time they are. So let's get a black tail in between, and then we'll keep looking for elk. Going north, always advisable to use the scent eliminator. The wind isn't it's the same everywhere, exactly the same. But as a rule of thumb, going north usually means use the scent eliminator. I'm usually not calling and waiting, I always move towards the animals, which also leads to some spooking at some time, or sometimes. So right now I only see the buck. Oh, two bucks. Medium size, and females calling. It's a very typical setup, 2 bucks and a few more females, sometimes 3 bucks. There are 3 bucks, 160 to the 185, that's a nice one. And of course elk, you will not miss them here. I should look for cover. Thank you. Okay, so let's not waste much more time on these. .167 is a nice score for blacktails. There's somehow a gap above 170. There's not much. Usually when you look at the results and the competitions, there is a lot in the 160s and then there will be a few up in the 190s. And not much in between. So let's see, where are we? I could run either up here or up here. And I will take the left here if I can. And continue to look for tracks from elk bulls. More cows in the area. Although this one appears alone. There's yet another herd. So in this area there's a lot of elk spawning as well. But it's not quite as packed as down here in the east, in the eastern corner. So sometimes you run a while without actually finding anything. You can also place a tent in this area and then just fast travel to it to bridge that middle part that is not really very active. But going from here, I'm really expecting to see a few more herds, especially bulls, of course. And here they are. And through the running, I ran into a set of a herd of bulls, or at least one bull. He was sleeping. They get up and run away very quickly. So he came in here, laid down to sleep. So this track is very young. He came here, laid down here, and got up again and ran. So let's go after this bull. Maxes out at 440 kilograms. Not likely a huge trophy. Maybe he wasn't alone. These are from deer. I'm seeing all these tracks and I'm trying to look at them. These are deer tracks and I'm not really looking for the elk. So let's go focus on that. I came from the south, so it very likely ran straight north. There's the next track. So as you can see, there are elk around here. And you can really find them all the way up. Not quite to the very north, but they go quite a bit up there. Nicely hidden, this one. So the higher tracking level, of course, is very useful, but not just for the better estimations, but also you can see the tracks from further away. The cone is more accurate. And sometimes a few meters more can make all the difference when you look for an animal. I mean, a few meters more where you can see the tracks. A few meters further away. So I'm thinking this one is going to be a medium-sized bull. Not super scary. Shouldn't take forever. So the bull is calling, that means it has he has calmed down. And of course I would like to use my tree stand as well. Let's place a scent trap here and then just wait in the tree stand. So a medium-sized bull, good weight, but score-wise, actually rather low. So the scent trap is down here. From this close, it's going to be rather easy. Okay, so let's pick this one up. And I think we've seen lots of elk. especially in the starting area. Lots of elk around this tent, and then you can see the road that I've been taken. You can easily go up here and find some elk here as well. Try it out. I hope you enjoyed, never got annoyed. Thank you very much. Stay in touch.